Oslo Skoving Kranservice.
For the delivery of its first LTC 1053.1E, Oslo Skoving Kranservice AS decided to really hit the ground running during the presentation. The company not only invited the local mayor to the celebration, who unveiled the crane and cut the symbolic ribbon, but also many of the company's customers and competitors. When the crane was demonstrated at this event, it was connected to a Liduro battery pack. If there is not enough power on site, this battery pack is usually sufficient for a whole working day in normal operation.
This option is absolutely crucial for us, mainly because we focus on areas close to the city centre, including the city of Oslo. From the 1st of January 2025, zero emissions will be mandatory on construction sites. We'll then be in a strong position. We know that other companies are now following suit, and we're very happy about that. But it's absolutely crucial for us to strengthen our position on the urban market with zero emissions.
In Norway, we are focusing very strongly on the green transformation. The city of Oslo has decided that parts of the city centre will be emissions-free for all vehicles from 2025. Property developers, the city of Oslo and government contractors are demanding emission-free machines.
My name's Siv Heger. I work for Skoveng Kran Service. I've been working as a crane operator for almost 6 years, and I really enjoy it. At the moment, we're on a construction site where we're building a multi-purpose hall. This 50-ton crane here, an LTC 1053.1E, is a little different from other cranes because it's electric, or rather it can be operated with electricity. We have three different amperages that we can work with, 125A, 63A and 32A. Everything on this construction site runs on electricity because it's supposed to be environmentally friendly. The construction site is located in the city centre. There's a school nearby, as well as residential buildings. This crane can be sent to many different jobs and locations. It's very manoeuvrable, which benefits it in special applications where space is tight. And the fact that it can be powered by electricity means that it can work indoors. When we work outdoors, as we do now, there are few noise emissions. It's a bit unusual that you sit in the same cab from which you control the crane on the construction site when traveling on the road. This is a small change that you have to get used to at first. But so far, I've had very good experiences in the short time I've been driving it. Because the cabin can be positioned 8 to 9 meters upwards, you have a better overview of the construction site, of the things around you. The crane here is new. It's the first in Norway to be powered by electricity.